now we're discussing the permanent compound tissues. And in these compound tissues, we have to talk of two, that is xylem and phloem. So first, let us talk about xylem. And as we are talking about xylem under compound tissue, that means xylem is made up of different types of cells. In simple tissues, all the cells are of same type. Whereas here, the cells can be of different types, or rather they are of different types. And all those cells which make xylem are called xylem elements. They are called xylem elements. Now what all or which all types of cells would be considered as or would be kept under xylem elements? The first are vessels or tracheids. Now vessels are found predominantly in angiosperms and tracheids are found in gymnosperms. We'll be talking about the structure also. The second type of cells which are found in xylem are known as xylem fibers. And xylem fibers are nothing but sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma fibers. These are long, slender cells. And the third type of cells which are present are called xylem parenchyma cells. And as the name tells us, these are thin-walled parenchymatous cells. Vessels and tracheids, they undergo lignification. That means at maturity, they are dead. Xylem fibers, we have already seen, these are sclerenchyma fibers. And at maturity, they are also dead. Xylem parenchyma is the living tissue with primary or simple cell wall. So this is the only living type of cells which are present in xylem. Now let us take the structure of vessels and tracheids and then we'll draw the complete xylem. Vessels and tracheids. Both are tracheids. Both are lignified cells, but there is a difference in the shape. Vessels are long column-like cells and they are placed one over the other. The wall is lignified, that means there is lignin deposition, and because of this lignin deposition, the inner content dies, that is the cytoplasmic material dies. And there is a space here which is called the lumen. In case of vessels, what happens is the end wall dissolves. That means this wall is going to dissolve. This wall also dissolves. Here also the wall dissolves. So basically we are getting a long narrow capillary tube. Plus, then let me draw one more row of these vessels here. These are cells again, and the wall, end wall is dissolved. So this is a long tube-like structure or a very thin pipe-like structure. There are sideways areas where this lignin deposition is not there. These areas are known as pits. So this is a pit. This is known as the lumen. And we get a very, very narrow, thin, pipe-like structure, capillary-like structure. These are vessels. Now, coming to tracheids. Tracheids have tapering ends. And they are also placed very close to each other, like this. Their walls are also lignified. And because of this lignin deposition, they also are dead at maturity. So this is one more. They also have pits, but the pits are on the wall which is in contact with each other. So the pits are going to be here. Then in this case, the pits would be here. The pit would be here. Now if we have to understand the flow of water in these two pipe-like structures. How is the water going to move in the vessels? The water is going to move straight up. It can go sideways also and straight up. Whereas in this case, the water has to go in, then up, then again sideways, then up and again sideways. So if there are turns, bends in the path of anything flowing, the rate of conduction is not going to be that efficient. And that is why vessels are more evolved type of tissues as compared to tracheids. And that is why we know that angiosperms are more evolved than the gymnosperms. So this is the basic difference between vessels and tracheids. Both are lignified, both are hexagonal, polygonal cells. If we take a section of the vessel, then we would find these kind of polygonal lignified cells. And in certain areas, we are also going to see these pits. If we draw the tracheid, then also we are going to see the same kind of polygonal, hexagonal type of cell. And we would find the lignified wall. And here also there would be pits. But there is a difference. In this, the lignified wall is thick as compared to tracheids. This is like if we compare a thinner straw and a thicker straw. The thinner straw would have a narrow lumen and the thicker straw would have a wider lumen. Thicker in the sense is not the wall, it is the lumen part. So if this is a pipe which is a wider pipe, this is a pipe which is a narrower pipe. And how is this difference achieved? This is due to deposition of the lignin material. So because of lignin deposition, the wall of vessel becomes thicker and its lumen becomes narrower. In this case, the wall is thinner and lumen is wider. This we would again discuss when we come to different types of woods. So this is the lumen. In case of tracheids, you find that the lumen is wider as compared to the vessels. So both are thick wall. This is also lignified and thick wall. This is also lignified and thick wall. But if we are comparing vessels and tracheids, then the wall of vessel is thicker as compared to that of the tracheid. And the lumen of tracheid is wider as compared to the lumen of the vessel. Now we don't have to draw fiber again separately. It is the same sclerenchyma fiber and xylem parenchyma. So let us try and draw the complete tissue together. So this would be our vessel, thick wall, and we find these lumens also here, or sorry, the pits also. And now let us draw the parenchyma cells. So these are thin walled cells, which are parenchyma cells, loosely arranged, which have intercellular spaces. And now let us draw these fibers. So here we are drawing again thin wall, but we are not showing the pits because the fiber which we made was a long structure and there was deposition of lignin all over. So this is the xylem vessel. These are the xylem parenchyma cells, and these cells are xylem fibers. So if we make the tissue, then without even labeling, the way we are drawing these cells, we can identify. If we see lignified wall with lumen, that those are the tracheids or vessels. Fibers with thick wall, but we don't draw the pits here. And parenchyma is thin wall with intercellular spaces. So this is how the complete xylem tissue would look, which is made up of vessels or tracheids. Angiosperms have predominantly have vessels, but they may have few tracheids. Gymnosperms have only tracheids. Xylem fibers are present in both, and parenchyma is also present in both. Now we would write two more terms when it comes to xylem. The first form xylem is known as protoxylem. Protoxylem is first formed xylem, and metaxylem is later formed xylem. So the xylem which would be formed first when the plant tissue is being formed, at that time whichever xylem is formed we'll call it protoxylem, and the xylem which is formed after the protoxylem, then that xylem would be called metaxylem. Normally, protoxylem vessels are smaller. So these protoxylem vessels are smaller and metaxylem vessels are larger. We will draw these things when we come to various kinds of conditions like exarch and darge conditions. But this is one type of compound tissue. And we also know that the function of xylem is conduction of water. So it is responsible for transport of water, and that is why vessels are better as compared to tracheids. It's simple. If we have to pump water from an underground tank to say second floor or third floor, and we have a pipe which we have put, once you start pumping it, if it is a straight pipe, it straight away goes up. And if you decide to take it, like you take the pipe to the first floor, give it a bend, take it on the side, then let it go up, again take a bend. So here, the pressure or the efficiency of the transport would not be that effective as compared to that straight pipe with a pump. That is, in case of plants, it is going to be transpiration pull. So because of that pull, water would be transported in a better and an efficient manner through vessels. And that is why angiosperms are tall plants. Because of these vessels, the water can be conducted to the topmost leaf very effectively. Though the force which helps is transpiration pull. Now this is about one compound tissue. In the next part, we'll take up phloem, that is the other compound.